Okay, Jamie, so you know my favorite thing about you?
What's your favorite thing about me?
Well, you're still above ground. I like that, right? Yeah, a little scared last year, but you're good now, right?
Yeah, I'm good.
You're good now, right?
Yep.
So Warner Elite in the house, right? I love my little 922 Junkyard Dogs. You know that, right?
Junkyard Dogs,
yep. Yeah, you guys do that well.
Yeah.
You know, I was talking to Travis Crabtree. He's down in your, from your neck in the woods. He's a Claymont boy, right?
Yeah.
And he told me there's just nothing about, you know, 922ers are just a different breed.
Yeah.
You guys get some tough kids, man.
How do you take
that toughness with what you guys are doing at Warner Lee and really put success on the mat?
Well, we just try to show them the best technique we can, and they're real gritty. They like to get after it, and just natural killers, man.
They are natural killers, right? So you guys got an NCAA champion in the family, right?
Yeah.
He's pretty good. I like that guy. He just got the transfer. He transferred to Johnstown. Is he healthy yet?
Nah, he's still hurt a little bit.
What is it, shoulder?
His knee.
Knee? Yeah. Okay, so he hurt that earlier in the season, but you're going to be healthy in March, right?
Right.
So he's focusing on that Tyler Warner, you know, defending champ at 133. But when you look at guys like that, you got your Cody Garbrandt. You got all these guys, man, who are just tougher than nails.
Yeah.
Right? What do you think you guys do differently down there in the 922?
I'm not sure. If you hear people talk about us, they say we fight you for a peanut butter sandwich. So they said they'd rather run into anybody in a back alley other than somebody from Erickson or Denison. So I don't know. I really don't.
I'll tell you what, when I see the pinstripes, I start sweating.
Yeah.
And I get a little nervous. I'm not going to lie to you.
Yeah, the pinstripes, you see the pinstripes, they're Claymont's original pinstripes, but, you know, not much affiliated with Claymont anymore. So.
I mean, the pinstripes still make me sweat.
They still make you sweat?
Some guy beat me up, maybe Armstrong. This guy beat me like he stole my lunch money, right? Where are you guys focusing now? Who do you guys affiliate yourself with now?
We still have just Tuscarawas County in general. We have Carrollton kids, we have Claymont, Indian Valley, Dover, Philly, Malvern. We're just trying to help the area wrestling out.
When you look at, you know, coming to something like the defensive duels, right? You guys were here last year. Once again, you know, you were still above ground. I was super excited about it. But, you know, when you come back to an event like this, what do you want the kids to get out of it?
Exposure to the great national level competition, to see where they're at, to make them understand what they need to do to get better. They might not be doing all the little things right, and might come here and get an eye-opener and decide, maybe Coach knows what he's talking about. Maybe I'll listen a little more.
Not even 90 minutes down the road from you guys, right?
Correct.
It's a quick buzz up here, right?
Yep.
You guys going home tonight or you're staying down here?
No, we're staying.
Staying? Yeah. You going to go check the dual meet out tonight?
I'm not sure. I've watched a lot of college wrestling, and not sure I need to see another one tonight.
No? Okay.
I'm going to go get something to eat and hang out with the wrestlers and, you know, just tell some stories.
Okay, so you guys have fun when you come here, right? It's about the experience with the kids and stuff.
Absolutely.
Like that, right?
Yep.
All right, when you you're planning something like this, do you guys go out and do Tulsa and all that too?
We have a few kids that travel to Tulsa and Reno. I've never been there. I'd like to take the boys there, but I just haven't made that trip yet. And someday I'll get there. But we wrestle, you know, Pennsylvania, Ohio, West Virginia. Three of the better states in the country. So I think we're getting that quality of wrestling right here close to home. And but like I said, I'd like to make the trip to Tulsa.
You're like 90 minutes from everything. You're 90 minutes from within
Pittsburgh.
Cleveland,
Columbus.
Youngstown, Columbus. It's like a great location,
right?
If you look at it. Like, it could be a place where like an RTC, like a regional training center, could actually take roots where you guys are.
Right.
Proximity-wise, I don't think you can beat it.
Right.
The airport, everything. I mean, you're right there, man, right?
Yep.
And look at all the Division I and II programs around there, and Division III programs.
Yep.
And it's pretty good. Not a little thin on JUCOs, but
right.
And NAIA, but man, you look at where you've got. You're in wrestling country.
Right.
Right? Do you think that helps the kids? Like, you know, I think we talked 922 guys, like, they're just gritty guys, right?
Yeah, they all have dreams and to go wrestle in college. I mean, be a Division I NCAA champ. But there's nothing wrong with Division II, Division III, like you said, NAIA, some of the best wrestlers in the country, and JUCO. But, yeah, we have a Claymont kid that wrestled JUCO, and he's going to lock Haven next year. So.
Just saw that.
Yeah. So
the guy, that's happy. The guy he gave Rocky Jordan all he could take in the state finals.
Yeah, like 5-3.
Probably should have maybe gone to overtime the way I watched it. Right.
There was stalling call. Probably should have happened.
That's how it goes, man.
Yep. Yeah.
All right, Coach. You guys got dinner and everything. I'm going to go catch this dual meet. You got anything else for me?
Nope. Stop and check us out down Warner Lee.
All right. Remain above ground. Until next time we talk.
I'm going
to try. I'm going to hold you to it.
Okay.
All right. It's good to see you, man.
Might not see you until next time. I'll see you at junior high state and grade school state, but I'll be above ground.
All right, Coach. Good luck.
Thank you.